Good evening to you, and thank you for joining us. Two state groups are suing Indiana to extend its deadline to turn in absentee ballots. Common Cause of Indiana and the state chapter of the NAACP want the deadline extended further than noon election day. This comes after election leaders are faced with growing pressure to allow no-excuse absentee voting for this upcoming election. That's from the threat of COVID-19. Newsstand's Richard Solomon joins us now live in our newsroom tonight. He shares what people's plans are for the upcoming election.
The coronavirus pandemic has impacted nearly every aspect of our lives. And yes, unfortunately, voting falls into that category as well. So today I ask people what their plans are for voting this fall. Do they want to do that in person or send that ballot in through the mail? Some tell me they want to avoid crowds as much as possible. Debbie Davis says she'll be voting by absentee mail ballot this fall election.
I have time to think, be by myself, consider the options, who's on the ballot.
Davis told me the main reason she made this decision was because of COVID-19. She voted absentee for the primary election.
It's more convenient. You don't have to be around other people and worry about spreading if you're not feeling well that day, or maybe someone else isn't feeling very well that day. Just safer to stay at home.
But others feel differently. Trish Allen says she plans to vote in person this fall.
It's going to be a big decision this year. And the more people to vote, hopefully the right decisions made. It'd be more beneficial for me than absentee voting.
But Sullivan County Clerk Tanya Bedwell says the mail-in ballot has become very popular in her community.
Sullivan County, our absentee ballot applications in the primary, it went up almost 500% than what we had in 2016 presidential election.
Bedwell says they're working to keep in-person voting just as safe as mail-in.
Well, right now, safety is a concern. Well, there's health check at the door. Mm-hmm. State has provided PPE for us to use, masks, hand sanitizer, disinfecting spray. Everything will be disinfected after each voter.
Bedwell says they're even working on getting a cleaning crew for the polls. But to Allen, it doesn't matter which way you do it. She says just simply,
just get out and vote.
Bedwell says for Sullivan County residents, you can request the application for the mail-in ballot now. She says her office will send out those forms the week of September 14th. Reporting in the newsroom, I'm Richard Solomon, News 10.